a bit of traveling today. So I will ditch all the traveling stuff because our plane got delayed for 2 hours. Then we stuck in massive traffic while we were getting to our hotel. The main purpose of this video and that trip is... This is the biggest schnitzel in my life. Apart from jokes, this is the second day we are on location in Germany. Big, big secret. There's a massive drilling thing. So I'll film it with my FS7, with this one as well. I will do some drone stuff. And I'm going back to UK tonight. It's a lot of driving involved. 2 hours to get here. Now we need to get back to the hotel. And then I will take a taxi to airport. Then I will fly. Then I will take my hired car, drive from Heathrow to Southampton. Let's get back to my studio. Good to be home. This was a little vlog about my last week's trip. Didn't have time to vlog properly, but at least something. For the last year, I'm shooting a lot of stuff myself. Usually I don't. Usually I direct or supervise to make sure I'll be able to work with the shots in post. There are several reasons for me to shoot videos myself though. I started to look at the works you've sent me for art advice. Thank you very much. A lot of emails. And there are some really, really good 3D works in terms of how they look like, but sometimes there is an absolutely random transition between shots, or shots are really disconnected in video. I'll mention these things in the first episode, but I wanted to point out the importance of good relationship between cinematography and VFX. The thing is that VFX is very closely related to real world. And I'm not talking about photorealism. Cameras, sensors, lenses, depth of field, motion blur, to name the least. Knowing these things and how they work in real world will massively help you with your CG projects. Even if you're creating still images only, composition, framing, lighting, all these things. I started exploring photography long before I started 3D. So when I started to learn 3D, I already knew that it's a simulation of real world camera. Now I'm mostly shooting videos and producing VFX, not that much of still imagery, but still, what I'm doing in real life massively helps me with my sequences. Also, when I'm shooting videos myself, there is no one else to blame if something doesn't work out in post. I have full control over what's done. It speeds up the education process and helps to grow creatively. Continuity of shots, planned transitions, movements, angles, storytelling, and so much more. All these things is something you as a VFX artist have to know. I'll explain even better. I'm not saying you can't learn these things doing 3D sequences only. You can, but much slower. What is faster, to create a decent 3D scene, re-render it 100 times before you figure out your sequence, your edit, or grab a camera, go shoot something and learn with each video you make? Answer is obvious. I'm just sharing it with you because I experienced it myself and I know the benefit from shooting videos and photos myself. If you don't want to mess with cameras or you can't, just start paying attention how movies are made. Cuts, transitions, angles, logics behind the shots. Cinematic look is much more than just colors. Bonus! My first ever educational video I made was about lenses and their focal length. There's the link. Check it out, it visually shows how different lenses' focal length affects the look of your scene. And this is just a tiny example why you should know real-world cinematography and photography. This is it for this short video. Nothing particularly educational, but something you might want to think about. Peace!